Hi there! Welcome back to Let's Play Super Mario Bros. 3. I'm Duke, as always. You know, if there's one thing I hate, it's lazy bastards who don't update their LPs often enough. Don't you hate it when that happens? I know, I've been slipping lately. You might even say I've been slacking. I offer no excuses for my behavior, just an apology. I mean, I really haven't been busy or anything. I've just been lazy. And that's the tooth. I got a 50-foot S video cable, so I can connect my computer to my TV. So I've mostly just been lazing around on the couch watching downloaded cartoons and stuff. Yeah, I'm going to try to do better in the future. I'm going to try to get back to my one update a day schedule, at least one update a weekday. I mean, there's no reason I shouldn't be able to pull that off. And all I have to do is 5 updates over the weekend, you know? 5 to 7 updates. That's cake. I mean, it's not like I've been going out. Like I said, I've mostly just been sitting around on the couch. I'm just lazy. No ifs, ands, or buts. These kids got guts. Anyone remember that show? Guts on Nickelodeon. It was some physical fitness game show where kids compete. At the end, they climb up this big fake mountain, and the winner gets to take home a piece of the fake mountain. It was a terrible show, but I always wished I could have a piece of the aggro crag. I mean, it was like this big hunk of rock, and it looked radioactive or something. It was like this eerie, green, glowing, fake rock. It was awesome. I wanted a piece. Ah, the good old days of Nickelodeon. It's not like that anymore. I mean, Guts, you know, isn't the best example of shows on Nickelodeon, but still better than most of the crap that they show today. Let's see, there is The Adventures of Pete and Pete. Man, I love that show. That was probably the best show on the channel, really. Except for the cartoons, of course. Ren and Stimpy, Rocko's Modern Life, The Original Doug, the classics. Nowadays, the only thing on the channel worth watching is Avatar. And even that's a fluke. I don't think that's even owned by Nickelodeon. They're just, like, licensing it or something. I don't know, maybe not. But still, it ain't like the good old days. Or maybe I'm just getting old. I made it. So one thing that I've been considering doing for my next LP, if anybody has any recommendations, I was thinking of doing a Mario 3 ROM hack. Since you don't really see many of those around. I mean, there are plenty of Mario World ROM hacks, but you don't really see many for Mario 3. It's kind of strange. I mean, maybe it's just easier on the Super Nintendo, or maybe there's just no demand for it. I have a ROM hack that I've been playing on and off on my DS. On the NES emulator. Oh, come on, I was still flashing. Oh, bullshit. On the NES emulator, but, yes, I know I said I didn't have any flowers, like, last video or the video before that. Well, I'm blind. I swear to God. I can be staring directly at something and not be able to see it. I think they have a word for that. Boneheadedness. But anyway, like I was saying, I've been playing a Mario 3 ROM hack on and off, but it's not really very good. They didn't change a whole lot about the game, and it's kind of glitchy in places. Like, they have different sprites for some things. I don't know. I mean, I guess I could try LPing it. Whoa! Oh, Christ. Stupid sun. Yeah, we have the return of the angry sun. He's not just for deserts anymore. Well, I guess this is a desert. It's just white sand. When I was a kid, I thought it was snow. I didn't know there was such a thing as white sand. I was like, why is the angry sun on a snow level? I'm making myself nervous. I probably want to die more on these levels than I have any other part of the game. This is where it starts to get a little challenging. Well, World 7 is when it starts to get a little challenging. This world is when it starts to get a lot challenging. But yeah, like I was saying, if anybody has any suggestions for Mario 3 ROM hacks, I'll give it a shot. Oh boy, I'm coming up on the worst part of the game. I will probably end up using a cloud to skip over this level, but I have to at least try this level. I don't think I've actually played this castle in years. I almost always just skip over it. They're excessively nowhere. Excessively everywhere. Excessively to boiling pits of lava. With fireballs. Walls that you have to break through with your tail. Interesting. Takes me here. Hey, those blocks spell the letter H. That must be the way home. Not bloody likely. Oh, I hate this castle. I hate it so much. Whoa! That's a thwomp. So yeah, I would like to... Whoa! I would like to announce that I finally beat I Wanna Be the Guy. J-Man beat it too, which is, you know, awesome. It's kind of sad, really. I told J-Man started playing the game when I was at the final boss, and I ended up beating the game after he did, because I was stuck at the final boss for so freaking long. I have no idea where I'm going, in case you were wondering. I hope I'm going the right way. I don't think I am, but there's always hope. Let's try this door. That's a flower. That doesn't particularly help me. This looks promising. Whoa, I actually made it through that castle okay. Man, that's not as bad as I remember. I swear, my memory exaggerates how bad elements of this game are. Let's see, that takes us to a couple pipes. And we are well on our way to Bowser's Fortress. This is probably the strangest looking map in the game. There are those four weird mushrooms up there. I don't know what those are there for. And like, we're surrounded by castle turrets. But in the middle, there's like this weird pink castle that looks almost like it has an evil face. Oh well, I guess we'll get to this part on the next update. Tune in next time for more Let's Play Super Mario Bros. 3. See you later.